The Paul Francis Show. This is the Paul Francis Show. News, networks, and information. This is the Paul Francis Show.
You are listening to The Paul Francis Show, brought to you by Elm Tree Productions. For more details, contact www.paulfrancis.net. Why not follow us on Facebook at Paul Francis or Twitter at Irish Psychic? That's Irish _ Psychic. Why not text your request on 07837 627 942? That's 07837 627 942. Send your requests in right now. You are listening to The Paul Francis Show. Available to you on Spreaker.com, www.spreaker.com/ The Paul Francis Show. Visit our site on www.paulfrancis.net. That's www.paulfrancis, all one word, .net.
Quest for more. Do you have what it takes? Join us live or dead. Quest Paranormal.
dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.
Lady, good evening, you guys. Lovely to see you all in there. Helen, hi. Ages since I've seen you. Oh, yes. So, how's everybody tonight then? All good, I'm hoping. Welcome to this Wednesday night special edition. The only reason it's special is because we don't normally have it on a Wednesday. So,
welcome to the clearing.
Yes, indeedy. Welcome to the clearing. I hope everybody's good and you're all enjoying yourselves. And this is a beautiful summer night here in Cornwall. Good evening to Helen. Good evening to Kat. Good evening to Sharon. Good to see you guys. Funny that. Helen, Kat and Sharon, all in the same part of the world. Carla, hi. Good to see you as well. And that's the four people who are in the chat room at the moment. If you're listening to my voice but not yet in the chat room, then you should be in here talking with us. Come on, get in here. I hope you're all good. So, lots happening, lots of changes. And all good for good. One negative, though. Helen's going to laugh her leg off. Fitting in this wonderful, beautiful new aquarium yesterday, and I broke it. Yeah, broke it. How stupid am I? But apparently I went and see a specialist today and they said, you haven't broken it too much, it's easily fixed. I was like, oh my god, thank god for that. All the fishies are okay though. First thing the guy said, how are the fish? Oh, I'm fine, thanks very much. So, tonight, basically it's just open-ended readings, cards, angel numbers, that kind of thing. So, if there's something you'd like to hear, like to talk about, then do talk to me directly. And please, 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 copy and paste the show to your Facebook pages. Invite all of your friends, please. Any particular particular questions you want to put to me, we've now started a new section on Spiritual Quest called Ask Paul. I shall be looking at that and seeing what questions are in there and then answering them live here on the show. Coming up a little later, of course, we're going to be looking at the star signs for today. Welcome to Spirit Quest Radio. This is the Paul Francis Show. So come and talk to me live here tonight on Spirit Quest Radio. So, wow. Have a look. Kay, Maria, hi, welcome to the show. Kerry. Right, dear pet, like. As the color starts to fade. So, we have who's joined us since I've been working away on Facebook? Kerry's joined us. Kay's joined us. And Maria has joined us. So, one end of the UK to the middle of the UK to the south of the UK, it's all the way to the United States. Good to see. So what's the news, guys? Anything good? Good morning, good evening, Maria. How are you? Hi, Paul, did you get my message? No, I haven't seen your message. Tia, welcome. Okay, I haven't seen a message from you. No, I don't know. I don't know if I got it. Where did you send it? I haven't seen it here. It's important that you guys understand that when I'm working, I don't genuinely get to see a lot of the messages. So, send them to me, though. No, okay, I haven't seen that. Nice to see Tim in there. Tim, thank you so much for all your help yesterday. You are a superstar, you and Helen both. And big congratulations and wishing you guys all the very, very best in your new home. Lisa, hi, welcome to the show. I see that you're still on the side. And how was Mr. Richie last night then, Lisa? Any good? Actually, Tim, it's working out great, mate. It is actually calmed all right down, and it could be well been settling as well, something along those lines, but it's working really well. But thank you, mate. You did. Thank you so much for being so quick as well. It's absolute superstar. Absolute superstar. Yes, I'm good, Carla. Thank you so much for asking. And it's all great. Everything's moving along nicely. And, well, I hope you guys are all the same. So... what about, yes, Lisa saw the phenomenon that is Mr. Richie last night. I bet you he was great. I bet you he was really, really good, huh? He was a god. I can imagine he was. And I bet he did all of his top stuff. Oh, I wish I'd had the chance to go to see him, but unfortunately, one was working. If you would all do me a big favor, copy and paste the show to your Facebook site and invite all of your friends to come and have a chat. Well, Mr. Howard Jones, one of my absolute favourites. I love that. That takes me right back to the very early 80s.
Loving it.
But let's honour Mr. Richie. Hope you guys are all well. Hope you're joining in. I put a little thing up on Spirit Quest today called Ask Paul, where you can go in and ask me questions. Three people. Is that it?
Somebody turn on the lights. Who you gonna
I'm so sorry, that caught me right on the hop there. Anyway, I was just doing some stuff there and obviously people talking to me whilst I'm trying to do this, which I'm okay with. That's okay. The idea is for you guys to come and have a chat. Right, let's have a look at who has come into the room since. Angie, hi, good to see you. Today is our daughter's birthday, 15. She's 15 today. And a big happy birthday to you. So hello to Angie. Who else has joined us in there? Jojo's joined us in there as well. And it's filling up ever so nicely there in chat room. Just been talking to... I just had a message from a lady who has just contacted me and said, hey, Paul, can I ask you some questions? I'm fired away. And during the conversation, she said to me, I just wanted to talk about a medium we had, which was... terrible. And I said, well, okay, I'm sorry to hear that. The medium who was dealing with this person was texting whilst dealing with this somebody. Now, on behalf of all good mediums, I do apologize to any and everybody who's been in front of a crap moron who would be texting whilst trying to do mediumship. That person needs their phone rammed up their backside. That's what they need, okay? It's hard enough being a medium and having to deal with people not really believing in what you're doing. But when you get an idiot who's supposed to be out doing the work and texting whilst they're doing it. Oh my God, I don't know about you guys, but I just lost my temper. Oh, I tell you what, every single day I'm getting closer and closer to starting the psychic police. I really am. Jazzy Jazz and the Funky Bunch crew, happy birthday.
Well, hi Kat, nice to see you. Hello.
I think we should get together and create something, maybe call it the Psychic Police, and start ripping out these charlatans who are ruining people's lives and just dipping into them to remove finances from them. I really am so against this. No, Carla, no big breath and everything will be fine. There are idiots out there ripping people off and I'm not doing it anymore. I'm gonna start actually, you know, outing them. Anybody with me? We'll be right back. welcome to this very special Wednesday night edition. Not something we do on a regular basis. Oh, you can be absolutely sure there's only one Paul Francis, Lisa. Thank you very much. Hardworking. Underpaid. But I love what I do, so. There's much more in this. Rather than financial payment, there's a meeting of wonderful friends, long-lasting, long-life relationships. Well, hello, birthday girl, Jasmine. What's up, girl? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jasmine. Happy birthday to you. I think, Lisa, I'm going to have to take you on as my bodyguard. Sings in the house. Debbie's in the house. Hello, Debbie. I noticed that Debbie got a hello, or sorry, Johanna got a hello before I did. What's that all about? Lisa, well, I'm 5'11", built like a brick toilet. I love it. Great bouncing material. Johanna, sign her up. Lisa Nelson, personal bodyguard. Get her in there. That's what I'm after. Get it in there. I need protection. Especially from Johanna, Lisa. So just be on top of that. Because the loves me. Because the loves me. Johanna, read what you write, woman. Because the loves me. I've told you, stop sipping that wine after I leave the house. How many times have I told you that? How many times have I told you that? I caught her trying to pour it into her eyeball the other night. It's terrible. Honestly, it's just... Honestly. Anyway, welcome to this absolutely stunningly beautiful evening here in Cornwall. I'm sitting looking out the studio windows and the light is pouring through. It's like one of those pictures, you know, when the light's beaming through the windows. It looks like... don't you tell me to shush. Scouse. And I'm in the studio all by myself. That's why I'm happy. It's peaceful here. It's peaceful at the minute. No doubt that's going to be wrecked shortly. So I was thinking about doing a little experiment tonight. You guys up for a bit of an experiment? Boo. Boo. Bing bong bing bong bing bing bong bong bang bing bing bong bong bang bong bang. Mm, mm, mm. Right. So, yeah, we're thinking about... I'm thinking about... It sounds suspicious. Absolutely, Susan. I'm thinking about doing a little bit of an experiment with all you guys in the chat room. So, if you're listening to my voice but you're not in a chat room, then you need to be in the chat room to be a part of this experiment this evening. Just going to come to the studio now just to be a pain. You don't have to come here to be a pain. Oh my God, I'm going to pay for that. I am going to pay for that. I can imagine Jojo walking about with a t-shirt saying, I'm Paul Francis's bodyguard. That would be intriguing. I am nice, Lisa. I am always nice.
Stumpy's in the house. Who's in the house? Stumpy's in...
Somebody told me Stumpy rides horses. That's funny. She's the only woman I know can walk under a horse without having to duck. Lisa's my bodyguard, Johanna. You get your own. You got Stumpy. She's the eighth dwarf. Size 8. Lisa, those aren't shoes. Those are platforms. Last time I seen shoes that big, they were being towed behind a boat. La, 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 la. What a wonderful evening. And to think I gave up this beautiful evening of tranquility, peace and quiet just to come and do a show for you guys, and all you're doing is picking on me. All you're doing is picking on me. How bad is that?
Welcome to Spirit Quest Radio. Spirit Quest Radio. Spirit Quest Radio. The people's choice.
It certainly is. With over 3,000 followers now. Welcome to The People's Choice, Spirit Quest Radio. Live with you tonight with the Paul Francis Show. Paul Francis speaking.
Thank you.
Fisherman's Blues there, the Water Boys.
Yeah.
Woohoo! And a big hello to Alex is in the house. And who else did I see has come in the house there? Philippa. Hi, Philippa. Welcome to the show. Glad you're here. Did I see anyone else sneak in there? No. Kat says, Lisa says that maybe she could be Lionel's bouncer. No doubt she could be, but you're mine, so give over. Anyway, so Stumpy's in the house, and it's really good to see so many of you lovely guys in here tonight. Going to play another tune, and then we're going to talk about a possible experiment. Experiment. Would you guys like to do that? You need to answer me right now, just with a yes. All of you who are listening to my voice right now, and in the chat room, that is, by the way, and you're up for trying this experiment out, then I want you all to give me a yes right now. Go, quick. Let's go. Just type in the word yes and send it to me, or no, if you're not up for it. Okay? Send it to me right now. Yes or no. Yes says Kat. Good. Carla says yes. Stumpy says yes. Debbie says yes. Kay says yes. Lisa says, oh, poor Lionel. Philippa says yes. Tia says yes. Susan Singh says yes. Come on, keep it going. Kevin Mullane says yes. Come on. I'll tell my agent, says Lisa. That's not a yes. Oh, now she says yes. Hi, Kevin, says Carla. Kevin's Welsh. She's got, hello, Kevin. How are you tonight? See, isn't it? Tidy. Lovely. Oh, tidy. Give us a pint. Right. Okay, then we're going to do this. But here's the thing. If you're going to do this experiment, under the concept of experiment means you have to give everything the 100%. So it needs to be addressed and dealt with absolutely. Okay, so this is what I'm going to get you guys to do. I'm going to play a tune. Right after that tune, we're going to come back and we're going to talk about the principles or the perimeters of this particular little experiment. So, stick around and chill out and get yourself some paper and maybe a pen. I don't know, something along those lines. What do you reckon? Get yourself a pen, piece of paper and a pen. Try that first. If you can't find a pen, piece of pen and a paper, try a paper and a pen or a pencil or something along those lines. Anything that writes, basically. This is what we're going to need for you to do this with us tonight. Welcome to Spirit Quest Radio, the Paul Francis Show, and it is actually Paul Francis talking. So some of you are not too sure whether this is me or not. Actually, I've had some weird. Is this Paul Francis talking? Well, it was when I looked in the mirror. Rhythm of the night.
Look out on the street now. The party's just beginning. The music's playing.
Okay, one more tune to go before we have another bit of a chat. So settle back and listen to Adele.
Don't need to think it over. If I'm wrong, I am right. Don't need to look no further. This ain't lust. I know this is love. But if I tell the world, I'll never say enough, 'cause it was not said to you. And that's exactly what I need to do if I end up with you. Should I give up or should I just keep chasing pavements, even if it leads nowhere? Or would it be a waste even if I knew my best? Should I leave it there? Should I give up or should I just keep chasing? Fall and fly around in circles, waiting as my heart drops and my back begins to tingle. Finally, could this be it? Oh, should I give up or should I just keep chasing? Chasing pavements, even if it leads nowhere. Oh, would it be a waste, even if I knew my place? Should I leave it there? Should I give up? Or should I just keep on chasing pavements? Should I just keep on chasing?
And Alex has lost connection. Who's singing? It was Adele singing Chasing Pavements. I like Joe Dulce. Ah, shut up your face. Ed Sheeran. Photograph. Nice new song, please, Paul. I don't have it, Carla. I know it's not in the archives. Absolutely. I love Ellie Goulding. How Long Will I Love You? About 4.5 feet. I'm not sure.
Oh, anyway.
So I was going to talk about doing a experiment, didn't I? So just give me 2 seconds. I just want to pick a little piece of background music. There we go. Right. So experiment. And I'm trying to kind of like, see, on the Spiritual Quest, which is our big chat site on Facebook. We have a sister chat site, which is Coven of Angels. But anyway, on Spiritual Quest, we have every Tuesday night is what we would call fledgling night, where people who are learning or who want to practice or maybe who are returning to doing reads and that kind of thing can do reads for the general public. We back you up in doing it. We watch how you do it, and we then give you some little hints and tips and some advice on how better to develop. Curiosity to kill the cat, Kev. I haven't heard that one for a long time. I'll tell you who I was with last night. I was with the guitarist from Haircut 100. I was with him last night. So, anyway, I'm moving forward. So, fledgling night, as I say, it's in the where we allow people coming back in to practice and come back in. Yes, Kerry, you should come back in. You've done readings for me in the past, and they were spot on. And so tonight, we're going to do a little bit of an experiment, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you into a little bit of a meditation, a very short one, so don't worry about that. It's not going to, you know, it's a meditation I'm going to bring you back into in a bit. Then I'm going to get you to open up, and I want you to be drawn to anybody in the chat room, any person. Okay, no pressure involved here. Do not think for one second that we're going to see whether you get this right or not. Nothing. Okay, and that person could very well be me or Johanna. You know, it's okay. You can select on either of those. But we want you to. What I want you to do is, once we bring you into the meditation, go with me 100%. Okay, go with me 100%. And be drawn to anybody that's in the chat room with us right now. And what we can do is focus that energy and see if you get something. It can be one tiny little thing, can be a little bit of a read, can be a big read, it's your call. And let's see if we can do that for somebody in the chat room tonight. All right? Now, what it is, I have been telling people for a great many years that every human being born is psychic. Now, I totally and utterly believe that every human being is born psychic. A lot of people won't accept the word psychic, but they will go with the concept of gut reaction, gut feeling. Now, whatever. I don't. You know, you can call it fork handle. I don't care. They don't like to be called psychic, but they'll go, well, my intuition is good, and my gut feeling, my gut instinct is good. Go for it anyway, Kev. Don't worry about it. Just relax back and just go for it. So, just pick anything, anybody. And do you know what? If you just keep saying, if you say, for example, and I'm only making this up, so this is not me doing a read for anybody. If you keep saying, like, listen, I don't know what it is, but around you, I keep seeing the color yellow. And that's all you see. That's okay. Totally okay. Present that to the person, and you never know. That person could be sitting wearing a yellow t-shirt. The walls could be yellow. They were talking about yellow paint. It doesn't matter. But a psychic reading is a reading that is based off here. Spiritual readings are something different, so don't worry about that, okay? So a psychic reading is something of the physical or the metaphysical, and spiritual readings is when we deal directly with those who have crossed ahead. Speaking about those who have crossed the head, she's just arrived. So, we're going to do that in a little bit. I'm going to take you guys into a little bit of a meditation. And then I'm going to get you to get a piece of paper. Be drawn to somebody in the chat room. Which could, as I say, could be including me or Johanna. And just let it go. Don't think about it. Just write down whatever comes into your heart, head, feeling, thought, visual, sound, audio, whatever. It doesn't make any odds, okay? So we're going to be doing that in a little bit. And that's what we're going to do. That's a little bit of an experiment. Remember, it is an experiment. It's not me looking at you going, you better get this right. There's only one person that has to get it right all the time, and that's me. And I don't get it right all the time. So don't worry about it, okay? A little bit later on, I'm going to see if I can find any Curiosity Kill the Cat, but I'll have a look at that in a bit. So, get yourselves ready. Relax about it. Don't overthink. Don't think, oh my God, I better get this right. It doesn't matter. That just what I want you to do is start opening up your energy, opening up your feelings, your thoughts, and just go with what comes into your mind, in your head. First thing that comes into your head, doesn't matter what it is. But if you see somebody in that room, and when you have something for them, then we'll deal with that in a bit, okay? That's very correct, young Kerry Carr. It is not meant for us to understand it. We're just to deliver it, okay? So This is very much a fledgling event. This is something I teach people who are moving into this area, who are starting to develop. And what I'm teaching you here to do is just open up your energy, and then you'll be able to accept that. And Kev, you would be surprised at how often your energy is telling you business decisions. You'd be very, very surprised, young man. Anyway, going to put a wee tune together right now. So right after this, we're going to come back and I'm going to bring you into that meditation. So in about 1.5 minutes time, we're going to do this little bit of a meditation. I'm going to bring you down in, I'm going to open you up, and then we're going to have a wee experiment just to see. And by all means, feel free to do it on me. It's okay. Okay, so I'm just getting prepped in here in the studio to be sending you guys out all the relative energy. And at the same point, don't worry, I'm actually going to be protecting you guys all at the same time as well. So, would you like to talk while I'm doing this, woman?
What do I need to talk about?
I don't know. It's never stopped you before.
Right, I'm in the big chair. Hey, it's nice and warm, this. Oh, did you hear that? That is not nice at all. Not nice. It's always horrible to me. What? He's really horrible to me. So I think we just all gang up on him. Right, so what are we doing to...
Like you don't do that normally.
We do it all the time. Lost sound. Can everyone hear me?
You haven't lost sound. We're okay.
I'm saying they've lost. Well, we haven't on our end, but they're saying they can't hear anything. Hey, Angie. Sound keeps on going, Debbie's saying. We keep losing you, sis. I'm sorry. I know. It's Paul. He's probably doing it himself.
You're not talking into the microphone.
It's going to the full thing there.
Yeah.
See what I mean? God. It's having a go again.
Always argues.
It's my job.
It's not your...
It is my job.
And I wonder if I'm going pig and grey.
Hey, Kevin, as I know you were in. You've been on the wine again. What? I always pay attention.
When?
When I'm sat here and I'm listening to you. I pay attention all the time.
Fire.
Yes, I do. Right, so I've just come back from doing the first mint.
Barbados?
No, not Barbados. Go on, have one of me sweets. I don't mind. He's got off and left me alone. How bad's that? Right, you just... Yeah. Yeah. I was like, I want to kill him. I've just got back from doing the first mentor for the new Wicca sisters. So a lot of them are in the room at the moment because they've just followed me in. So obviously,
not in this room.
Not in this room, no. Yeah, did you give me them toenail clippings that I needed for later? I'm joking. Oh, that is disgusting. No, I don't need that. Thanks very much. So if you would like to listen to a Wicca section, are we going to be doing a Monday, but go back to a Monday, Paul?
Tuesday.
So, not on the, look, they're all laughing at you.
Why?
Lisa's telling me that I'm the one that needs the bouncer. She's saying she needs to protect me against you. No, I'm not joking. I'm not joking. Like Kay said, you know, little love taps, that's all.
She beats me every night. Beats me. Actually physically beats me.
See, and he said he would never lie, and he just did. He just did. Live on air. He's just, yeah, it's just a little love tap. Let's not go there, shall we? Okay, so all I want to know is if anybody would be interested or you guys would be interested in a little Wicca section, if you've got questions or anything that you want to know about with regards to the crystals and what we do, like to know. Yeah, you should believe me, Susan, because it's true. You know I don't lie.
Liar!
You know, you know I don't lie. And he beats me. I've got to be honest, he does.
Oh,
he beats me.
Oh, my God. Pull your nose back. It's
going to
knock over the computer.
I'm not that bad. I'm not that bad. You know what? You'll never get any better. That's all I'm saying. Ooh. Yeah, see, look, Lisa's saying you're a little fibber, Paul.
Oh, God. And you're not.
I am not. I'm not, look, they don't believe you. Look, every single one of them are saying. What? See?
They
look, you are. We know, Paul, you're telling fibs.
Well,
that's what you're saying.
I'm not.
I don't. Happy birthday, Jasmine. I've seen that lovely picture of you when you were two minutes old.
You sound like a female Derek Acora.
Yeah, well, he's hello a scouser
there
as well.
Hello there. Hello there, Jasmine.
All
right there, Jasmine.
He's nicked me mic.
No, you've nicked mine. Well, see the way the mic works because I talk properly into it? Everybody can hear me clearly through your mic, even though they can't hear you through your mic.
Go on, tell them you can't hear them.
Yeah, anyway.
Yeah, Angie, us girls stick together. Yes, we
I'm
do.
Back.
I'm back.
I can go again, though, if you want to run the show by yourself.
No, you're okay.
Do you think we should set up a show for just specifically for Johanna called The Wicca Show?
No, they don't want to hear me bleating on about Wicca for
well,
2 hours.
Really hear you, bleating on.
You love it. You ask questions. Nothing wrong with that. I want to hear questions from everybody. So if everybody would like us to do a Wicca section, I'm happy to do that. A lot of the Wicked Sisters come in on the chat, so they'll be able to answer some questions as well.
Did you hear what she said? Wicked Sisters. Wicked
Wicca,
Sisters.
Not wicked.
Honestly, I've seen her do this, guys. You need to be careful, because she runs about bonfires butt naked.
No, that's Summer Solstice. That's next Monday, that.
Oh, my God.
On the beach.
Thank God I'm working.
Me and Shorty.
Her and Shorties. You see what I mean?
No,
runs
no.
around butt naked.
Me. No. Me and Shorty, Holly's going, and we're taking Madison, so be careful what you say.
My Madison?
Oh, yeah.
Or our Madison, I should say.
Our Madison is
That's
coming.
My daughter we are talking about, by the way.
Yeah. She's coming to Summer Solstice for her first Wicca ritual.
My own blesh and flood.
Poor thing.
She's going to come back hovering, speaking things like, I know you.
Oh, I'd be very careful what you say to her once she comes back.
Boom, frog.
Do you want your seat back?
Well, if you can chat on for a bit longer if you want. We've got to do this experiment in a minute.
Okay. What's the experiment? Because I missed that bit.
You were sitting beside me when I said
it. I was doing something.
No, you weren't. You were doing something.
I was doing something because I have
But
this
you weren't
ability.
Sitting beside me.
Listen.
No.
I have.
No. See, I told you she lies.
Listen, I have this ability when Paul's talking to like completely block it out.
That's constantly and permanently and always on.
It's not. It's not constantly and permanently. It's at will.
Well, you see, the thing about it is I do the same because when you're talking to me, all I can hear is Scouse!
Yeah, and I know when you're not listening because you just go,
yeah,
yeah.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Yeah, that's a good idea. Oh, I think that's a really good idea.
He does it all the time, and it's
and really I usually ended up with Tuesday, around about Tuesday, I think.
Tuesday? What happens with Tuesday?
No idea, but I have no idea what you said before either, so...
Yeah, and then I come back and he goes, where have you been? I said, I've told you. He goes, no, you never.
Like, let me give you an idea. Maya's school, literally, and I kid, this is not me exaggerating. Maya's school is no more than 5 minutes away. Five. All right? In fact, I've been known to take Maya to school and be back in the house in 8 minutes. Hour and a half. Later, she turns up.
An hour, not an hour and a half.
Hour and a half.
I get stuck on there.
You get stuck
phone
on
there.
You get stuck on what?
I get stuck on phone calls. You know, I do work
See?
As well.
See? Always full of the excuses.
There's not excuses.
More excuses? You got excusitis.
I have not. So what's this experiment then? Tell me.
You wouldn't be able to do it, so.
Why?
You're not good enough.
Did you hear that? See, degrading me again.
Degrading you?
See, he does that when he's got no response because he knows it's right. See,
my mother's watching over you. Remember, my mum's watching.
I know, I'm going to get a slap behind the head soon.
You're going to get slapped right on your head soon. That's not from my mother. Right, anyway, I'd best put a tune on because she doesn't know how to do it. Because she's...
She?
Yeah, she. Cat's mother. let's have a look now. I've got to stick. Right, I tell you what. I'm going to bring the ambience down a little bit, and we'll put this tune on, and then we'll come right back in to do the experiment together, all together. The whole idea was to play that song all together now, and then you just messed it up and going on about your Wicca. See you up for night time if I can't sleep, because sometimes I have to take pills at night because I've got a lot of pain, but I have to take pills at night, and you don't make me sleep. I just say, tell me about your Wicca. She hit me! Told you, she hit me!
When you try your best but you don't succeed, when you get what you want but not what you need, when you feel so tired but you can't sleep, stuck in reverse, and the tears come streaming down your face, when you lose something you can't replace, when you love someone but it goes to waste, could it
right now, I'm back in my rightful place in front of the proper mic.
Lights will
get yourselves ready, and we'll do this right after this. I can't believe you just farted.
Lights
absolutely beautiful song, and it kind of just sets the right tone for our little experiment. So what I want you guys to do is just literally settle back. Just do me a favor and settle back and let's move into this together. So just close your eyes. You don't have to worry about the pen and the paper or the pencil and paper right now. Just close your eyes and just listen to my voice. Literally, that's all I need you to do. And breathe in through your nose and just let everything go. Listening and only thinking about my voice, nothing else. Think only about the music in the background. The sound of my voice. Or what we like to refer to as the basics of life. Closing your eyes. Imagine you're sitting on a beautiful beach, clear blue skies, and the sun is anywhere in the sky that you wish. Rising, midday, even coming towards setting, whatever you like. The waters are beautiful, turquoise, and calm, gently, gently lapping. With every breath, hold, release the sound of the water just breaking on the beach gently. Imagine now you're sitting against a beautiful palm tree. It's gently shading you from the sun, but you're getting that beautiful tropical warmth. A gentle breeze coming through, cooling you down just enough. This is paradise. And with every breath in, falling deeper and deeper. Every breath out, letting go of any aches and pains, worries and stresses. Let your eyes scan the horizon, the water, forming a perfect line, sky, the water's blue. Just a little way off, you may hear the sound of dolphins. Beautiful singing sound a dolphin can make. Can't really see them, but you can just hear them. Continuing to breathe all the way in. Hold. Release. With every breath out, falling deeper and deeper, more and more relaxed. Listening to the sound of the water gently lapping on the beach. You continue to scan the horizon, looking further and further, as far out to sea as you possibly can, and where the clouds meet the ocean, start to see
say it may be an animal, person, thing, or even a color. Focus on the shape. Bring it into focus. Understand more and more what that focus is. Person, thing, animal, is. Understand it completely. Don't try and guess what it is. Allow it to show you. To come more and more into focus. I want to show itself to you. Don't try and second guess. Don't even try and understand why you're getting it. Just accept it. What I'd like you to do now that you've completely understood what it is you're being shown is now visualize in the room who it may be for. It could be anybody in our chat room, which includes Johanna or myself. Don't think about what it is that you've got. Think about the person it's for. Understand that it's for this person. Don't try and understand why it's for this person. Just that it is for a particular person. And very shortly, we will deliver it for that particular person. In the meantime, I want you to focus back on yourself. Notice that the water is coming closer and closer to your feet. Don't worry, this is meant to happen. With every breath in, bringing the water closer and closer. Until the water gently laps against the bottom of your ankles and hands. Notice how the water perfect temperature, but giving off an energy of the earth. Mother Earth is giving you an energy to help you. Allow the energy to work its way up your legs, through all of your muscles, through your joints that you need, your ankles and your toes. The water is carrying this energy toward you, but the energy will travel up through your legs, reaching into every muscle, every nerve, every bone, past the knee, the calves, to the hips. Allow the energy to work into the hips, around the waistline, moving up the spinal column, all through the muscular, up into the chest and back, to the shoulders and neck. Now working the way out, down the biceps to the elbows, working its way into the musculars and the joints, and the forearm, to the wrist, and the hands and fingers. feel that energy working its way from the feet all the way up through your body, your back and chest, neck, shoulders and arms, and now up the back of the head to the crown of the head, over the eyes and nose, down the cheeks, the chin and back into the neck again, and working its way back down the chest and back, hips, legs, knees, arms, ankles and back into the ocean. Allow that energy to flow all the way up, all the way back down. And each time it comes down, it takes with it all the worries, stress, some pain. Just write it down for whomever you might think it was for in the chat room. And remember, it's only an experiment. No one here is going to be looked at or judged. Not at all. We'll play a tune. And we'll go on back right after this.
Makes it out of sight, and everything's good in the world
There you go, when Smokey sings. Really great. Sorry I wasn't able to join in. I have people over, so I'm watching instead. That's fine, hell, no worries. Right, so let's have a look. So a couple of people said they couldn't hear my voice. They could only hear the music. Sometimes that's actually your brain deciphering, because obviously a lot of other people could hear my voice, but that's okay. And it also could be what you're listening to me on. That could be a reasoning. But here in the studio, it was showing my voice was way over the top of the music. So anyway, let's have a look. Let's go back. I can hardly hear Paul. Wow. Carlos says, wow, the bells are powerful, says Angie. Joanne is guided to Johanna. Philip is guided to Angie. Let's go move further on down. Who else is... Lisa was connected to Carla. What else have we got? Lisa felt a bit shy. Don't be feeling shy, darling. It really is... it's only an experiment. So don't worry about this. This is really quite cool. And Lau... What you can do, we can give you two options here. You can either put up here on the chat room, what you were kind of guided to, or you can PM it. He says, sneezing his head clean off. I'm allergic to Johanna. So, So you can either put, you know, I would love to see what you have were drawn to. And it, honestly, please, guys, don't worry about this. This is no way, in any way, am I going to be saying, right, okay, listen, you did that wrong, or you did that right. There's nothing wrong, because you're going to give exactly what you got. So it's absolutely correct, okay? And then I've got some connections that I have for you guys that I'm going to be sharing with you guys in a moment or two as well. So it is all good. It is all good. It's all good for the benefit of everybody, okay? Drawn to Lisa. My back has gone really hot. That's good, Kev. And the air is crackling around my head. That'll be the wine. So, okay, so that's good, Kev. So you're drawn to Lisa. So you're giving her the fact that you have... Your back has gone really hot, so there'll be back-related issues that you want to show her. And you've got a crackling feeling going on around your head. Now, it'd be interesting to see what... there you go. Lisa's saying, no, Kevin, no way. Go on, Lisa, then explain to what that is that means to you, okay? Explain to Kev what that means. Shen, we did an experiment about 10 minutes ago. And we're just now discussing the whole concept of the experiment. So explain there, Lise, what Kevin's little connection there means. Go on, just jump in there and sort of deliver that one, see how that comes out. It'd be really, really interesting to see that, how that works out.
Lovely.
Go ahead. I'm going to keep that music going in the background there. Let me just bring that back up. There we go.
I have spine disease, Jab. Wow. See, Kev, I told you you could do it. And the crackling around the head, what does that mean to you, Lise? And you've got vertigo. See that what Kev did? Tell you what, I'm going to be handing the reins over to Kevin soon. Excellent, Kev. Well done. And you you presented exactly what you got. And that's brilliant. Jen, focus. So you presented what you got there, Kev, and Lise took it. Now, Kev, you were already starting to talk yourself out of it before we begin. So that is how good this is. Well done. So let's go then. Joanne, do you want to present to Johanna what you got? Just do it on here. See, there's no pressure of any kind. I have a little double message for Kev in a second, which I'll deliver in a moment after we've gone through what you guys are doing. So send it through there. Let's have a look. Come on, share. Not share the singer. Share your message. Okay, Carla, please present what you got. I'd love to see it. Wow, Philippa. Excellent. That's brilliant, Deb. So what did you get there? I'm just going to read out Philippa's because obviously there's going to be a lot of people listening back to this and they're not seeing what we're seeing. So visually in the chat room, I'm seeing Philippa who has got connected to Angie and she has said, I got a snowman. And the other colour was orange. I think it was the carrot nose that was really standing out to her. Then I got an extended hand and someone was blowing butterflies off her hand. It was a lady blowing the butterflies off her hand and the butterflies were blue. And of course Angie's gone, OMG.
Oh my God.
Debbie was drawn to Carla because she looks like her daughter. Lisa says, I got an old wooden chest or trunk from wartime and old photos and letters. Wow, Lisa, well done. Wow, Angie. Angie replied with, my husband's got an orange shirt on tonight and I've got butterflies in my garden. Wow. Amazing. Carlo's seen me at the seaside. She says, Paul, I see you in a seaside. Thank you. So what did that mean to you, Carla? What was the message behind watching me at a seaside? Take care, Carrie, darling. We'll send you loads of energy and loads of healing and rest up and we'll catch up soon. Come on, Miss Singh. What did you get? Wow, Lise, that is perfect. Keep it going. I'm in love and happy doing it. I'm going to take out of that, Carla. I'm assuming you were thinking I'm in love and I'm happy. And you would be very, very correct. Oh, so they're LED butterflies, Angie. Beautiful. Now, look at the responses here for this just basic experiment that you guys weren't clued up to what's going to happen, and you did it right off the top. But wow. Sue, no problem at all. None at all. You do some seriously great readings, excellent readings, that I watch and I sit back and I think, wow, this lady is well gifted. Lisa, I would like to say that you have definitely got a gift there that you're tapping into, because you're seeing so much precision. I'm well impressed. Again, not judgment, just well impressed. Exactly, Susan. Susan says, I think it's amazing so many of you have done so well. You all should be proud. Johanna and I totally back that up. Totally agree with Sue there. Everybody's born with gifts. Every single person, Kay, is born with psychic abilities. Every single human being. We're all born with a psychic ability, and we unknowingly develop that ability through life. And then some of us take it a little bit further, like myself, and we develop it further and further and further. But everybody is born, and especially moms. Moms develop a psychic connection with their children during the pregnancy, which grows throughout life. Well impressed, Lisa. I think I might have to take Lisa under my wing. Mind yours. Right, I haven't seen Kev in there, but Kev, if you're listening in, I've got a message for you, my mate. First of all, 712 came up for you, so that means your faith and positive affirmations have put you on the right path. You're on a roll right now, mate. Miracles are around you. So keep up the good work. The card that was automatically chosen for you. Have faith and hope, because there's something positive on new on the horizon that you can't yet see. But you've got a feeling, or you've been working towards something that has been bringing you, that you were worried about. Maybe not too sure whether it was going to happen or what it was not going to happen. But it's on there. Keep the positivity going. You're doing the right things, Kev.
and that confirmation of the business affirmation will work out. I kind of get the feeling that you're putting your toe in the water, but you're afraid to step all the way in. Don't be afraid to step all the way in. It's going to work out. Right, so I'm focusing directly on Maria right now. Keep seeing 412 13 412 413. So let's have a look. Maria, this is gonna be this is going to be a kind of a double-edged sword for you. Just give me a second. Yes, Debs, I'll have a look at that in a second. Maria, listen. Listen, Harsh. Ask the angels and the archangels to come into your dreams and clear away any pessimism so that you may be filled with powerful faith of optimism. The angels and ascended masters surround you and your thoughts with love and healing energies. Absorb their love into your mind so that all your thoughts shall shine with the divine light. Wow. Absolutely wow. I'm also being shown something else, so just hang on a second there, Maria. Happy move to a new home or place of employment is in the works right now, Maria. This movement will usher in new positivities in new ways. Basically, a lot of great stuff coming your way, Maria. Have you got anything for me? I was just giving it to you. Shen, keep the positivity in here. No negative messages.
Nobody's ever drawn to me, Angie.
Yes, we are. You know we are. Come on, keep it positive. Debs. Let's have a look at Debs. Debs. Angels are helping you manifest your positive thoughts, affirmations, and visualizations into reality. Confused and indecisive because you do not have enough information, do more research and seek advice before making a bigger decision. That's the messages that came out straight for you, Debs, right then. I just closed my eyes and I said, let's help Debbie out here. Well, basically what it was saying, Maria, to kind of summarize it, was allow the
You're going to be moving either house or home. House, home, or work. And it's all positive. Beg your pardon. And to say, it also said, allow the angels to come in and clear your mind of all thoughts and allow divine light in there to help you. Sign went a bit. Can you repeat it, please? Oh, Debs, I put the cards away again.
Basically, it was, Debs, the angels are helping you manifest your positive thoughts and affirmations and visualizations into reality, but you need to also find out more information before making bigger decisions. That's what basically what it was saying in a kind of a little down, shortened down way.
Carla, I feel I'm being drawn to Carla right now. Give me a second. Okay, Carla.
The Ascended Masters support you and your divine purpose. They've been supporting you materially and spiritually. Let go of worrying and focus upon your mission. It is safe for you to be powerful.
It is safe for you to be powerful. You know how to be powerful in a loving way, and that benefits others as well as yourself. Kay, I'm drawn towards you now.
Your prayers, affirmations and connection with Ascended Masters have created positive change in your life. You're realizing the old, bringing in new wondrous news. Stay positive and your thoughts about yourself and your future. Stay positive about your thoughts and yourself about your future, Kay. Keep charging ahead. And don't take no for an answer. Expect miraculous solutions to appear for you.
Me.
Philippa. Get to work on your mission without delay. Even if you don't get prepared or qualified, your contributions of love and light, no matter how large or small, are needed in the world right now.
Wow.
More to this, Philippa. Hang on a sec.
Serena. I am the Archangel of Abundance. You'll receive the money that you need, as God is in charge of how you will happen.
So how it'll happen, so have faith. Wow.
I don't know, Shen, but it's showing here as it's peaking. So in other words, it's the my voice is being sent into the system, so it could well be your computer. Check it out. One of the things about doing what we do, it's okay if you are learning and you are practicing and you're starting to develop. It's okay, that's no problem at all. But if you are giving direct and focused messages, a medium or psychic must always take responsibility for the information they give. Okay? Now, I put up a new section on Spirit Quest the other day. Actually, it was today. Saying, post your questions to me today. Alex said to me, will I get my night care back? It's really about not readings. It's about information about how to develop, that kind of thing, all right? So, question was, how many spirit guides do I have? Well, there's no actual real answer to that. Basically, what that means is your spirit guides change, okay? Your spirit guides, you have one master guide and one gatekeeper, but you will also have a varied amount of spirit guides, okay? A varied amount of spirit guides. So, Alex, I'm actually answering your question that you posted up on Spirit Quest. So, about the amount of spirit guides we have. So, there is no answer to that because your spirit guides will change in abundance and regularly whilst you're developing. Mine changed in literally almost armies when I was developing through my career. I kind of work with 6 or 7 main guides right now, but that will change. I usually have on average about 6 or 7, but that will change as well as I'm started moving and developing more and working with the Ascended Masters and the higher archangels, and all of the angels. There's no higher than the other. We just refer to the archangels as a higher realm, but it's not really the case. But yes, it does change. So there's no direct answer to that, other than you will have the amount of guides with you that you need at that time. Yes, I would totally agree with that, Lisa, and that's pretty much what I just said. You have many guides and healing, and it will depend on what you're working with and who you're working on or where you are in your development. Well, I'm about to release a series of CDs on personal development, and they will take you to meet your guide and your gatekeeper. That's the initial outset, will take you to meet your guide and your gatekeeper. Because those are the two real main ones. Let's have a look. When a person crosses over and returns back to Earth in a new life, and they're able to come... This is coming from Cindy. When a person crosses over and returns back to Earth in a new life, are they able to come back to heaven to greet the rest of the loved ones coming to heaven? And will they know when they pass? I don't understand that. Let me read it again in case I've missed it. When a person crosses over, then returns back to Earth in a new life, are they able to come back to heaven to greet the rest of the loved ones coming into heaven? Or will they know when they pass? I don't understand that. Well, if you've crossed over and then you return to the Earth, you're here, you're this side, and you work with all the rules that go on this side. So I kind of need to get that question more verified and what you need to know. If a deceased person is reincarnated, can one still connect with them? No, because they're here on this side. They've gone from the spiritual to the physical. And they've left the spiritual to become physical. So they can't be in two places at the same time. If that answers exactly the question that was put to me. I don't know what the question was. It didn't make sense. No disrespect to those people putting it to me, but there we go. In relation to the change of guides, that happens constantly and very often it'll happen when you least expect it as well. And you may wake up one morning thinking, oh my gosh, I've lost all my abilities. That's quite common. Quite common. You'll realize you haven't. And you haven't remotely lost your abilities, not in any way, shape or form. So don't worry about it. I'm going to play a sweet song here for Lisa. Animal.
cry wolf. Hear the mouth to mouth like a moving heartbeat. In the witching hour, I'm running with the wind. A shadow in the dust, I'm like the driving rain, yeah, like the restless rust. I never sleep. I got death kneeling in my blood, but I need your touch, don't need your blood.
Now, I'm going to use one of my wonderful friends' response here, Shen. Philippa said, I'd love for you to do a show in New Zealand. And I said, absolutely, we'd do a show in New Zealand. And Shen said, New Zealand, wow, a long, long way ways away. No, it isn't. It's just it's on this earth. So it's just another place on this earth to go to. It's talking about the reason why I just chose these two particular people to talk about right now is just called the concept of limitation. The only limitations we have are the limitations we set for ourselves. It's important you get that in your heads. The only limitations we have are the limitations you set for yourself. Okay. For an example, I said to my daughter one afternoon, I showed her a picture of a home, a house I was going to buy. And the house was £580,000, something like that. And she said, my God, Dad, that's over £500,000. That's £500,000. And I said, Rosie, it's just a number. It's just a number. And what I was trying to teach her was that that number is only the limitation you set. If you set in your brain that I can't reach that number, then you just won't. It's as simple as that. You will not reach that number because you've told yourself you can't. The only limitations we have are those that we set for ourselves. So remove limitation. They said it's not possible to fly above a certain height. They said it's not possible to fly faster than sound. They said it's not possible to go outside the earth. They said it wasn't possible to go to the moon. If I told you, if I took you back 400 years and told you I was going to put 100,000 tons of metal and make it float, you'd think I'd lost my mind. But the Titanic was twice that. Alright, it floated to the bottom, but it floated away out before it went to the bottom. nothing is impossible, only the limitations you set for yourself. So remove that and get rid of that in your thought process. And if you've got people around you that say, yeah, but, get rid of them as well. Get rid of anybody who will set limitations for you. Get rid of them, all right? Because they're setting limitations. And limitations are not... there's no rules. Rules are just people setting guidelines that you can't break. Rubbish. Okay? Absolute total rubbish. Get rid of it. And get rid of anybody who's a yeah but person. Because they're the ones that are limited. And they'll limitate you as well. Get rid of them. Get them out of your life. You don't need them. So, in that position where we love our shan the bits, we do. But what I wanted to show you was that limitation is set in your mind. I can't do that because it's too far away. Crap. You can do whatever you like. Anything you want to do, you can do. Just put your mind to it. Put your focus into it and get past it. Okay? Stay strong. Stay focused. And believe in your ability to do whatever you want to do. Do you know what? We were talking about this today, Johanna and I. And I said, when I was a child, when I was around about 8 years old, and my family and we were all talking about, what do you want to be? And I said, I want to be a pilot. They went, no, you're not going to be a pilot. And I was like, yeah, I want to be a pilot. And they went, no, you won't be a pilot. And I was held back in primary three because I wasn't advanced enough to move past. And they were like, no, you're not clever enough. You're stupid. You're not good enough. You're blah, 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 yak, 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 rubbish. I am way past that ability now. I can fly helicopters. I can fly aeroplanes. I can drive cars. I can ride motorcycles. I can ride horses. I ride speedboats. I got over my fear. No, I haven't got over my fear of deep water. That's a lie. I still have a fear of deep water. I have got a fear of spiders, but I want to keep that because I got a kind of like a focus behind it. If I have a fear of spiders, then I won't get bitten by one. I'm getting better, but I still won't go near a tarantula. I don't care. Oh, it's all fine. Put it in your hand. No, I won't put it on my hand. I lived on my own for a little while and I had to get past the fear of spiders. But anyway, oh my, I'm just feeling it right now. Oh. So, there is no limitation other than that limitation you set for yourself. Literally. Okay? So, just while we're having a bit of a yarn here, maybe it's a really good idea that I have a look at the weather forecast for the UK tonight. Northern end of the country is steeped in rain. 12 degrees in Edinburgh. Belfast, 16 degrees. Rain with sunny spells now and again. Manchester, 16 degrees. Cardiff, 15 degrees but cloudy. London, cloudy with sun, breaks of sunshine, 16 degrees. St Helier, 14 degrees. Coldest part of the UK tonight, Aviemore in Scotland, 7 degrees. Thierry, 10 degrees. Wittering, 11. Barnstable, 11. Carlisle, 11. Heaton, 16. Bognor Regis, 16. Barnsley, 17. Gravesend, 18. Yeovilton, which is not too far. I don't get that. It said Yeovilton and where else did it say? Barnstable. No, it's Barnstable. Yeah, Barnstable and Yeovilton are beside each other. But Yeovilton is 20 degrees, yet Barnstable is only 11. You got Barnstable on the left, Yeovilton on the right. They're beside each other. Take me to Barnstable. Yet Yeovilton's 20 degrees. Anyway, Yeovilton is a beautiful place. I'll take you there one day. That's near Glastonbury. So that's the weather forecast tonight. And of course, we are in the Gemini house, the House of Gemini. So let's have a look at that. Your generosity and altruism, that's a good word, will be put to the test over the next few days. You'll probably help the underprivileged. After all, you've always felt concerned about humanitarian projects, but you've never actually gotten involved. Well, today this attitude will enable you to understand who you really are. You'll be able to learn a lot more about your motivations and keep that key to success. Out of 5 stars, you've only got 2 for love, though, and only 2 for mood. 3 for career, but only 2 for finance. So come on, keep that focus. Let's have a look at your money horoscopes there, Gemini. You have some thinking to do about your home. From decorating it to furnishing it to organizing it. You have a lot on your plate there. But there is some confusion in your closet relationships. Ooh, closet relationships. Whether your personal or professional communication needs to be clear and concise, lest you be understood. Because a lot is riding on this. Let's have a look at your career, shall we? Tend to your garden of work-related projects. You need to stay disciplined in order to produce the results you are hoping for. Stick to the schedule. Don't deviate from your plan. The more stable you are, the more you will accomplish. And you know what? None of it means anything without your health, so have a look at that. The best kind of exercise is exercise that you enjoy. You may not feel like doing the same thing every day, but it's sometimes easier to follow a routine. Just make sure what you do is appealing enough so that you don't skip out your workout. Oh my gosh, yeah, that was me, and I skip my workout regularly. You are prone to emotional intensity, and you can't let that determine whether or not you're going to get to the gym. Maybe there's a friend you could work out with to add that enjoyment. You know what? I tried that. I tried that with Johanna, but she never turns up. So, I went out and bought treadmills, I bought cross trainers, and all she does is look at them. The daily I Ching, that's for everybody, for everyone, okay? Today's situation is like water flowing between the walls of the deep, steep ravine. It is talking about real life situations that are going... Oh, do you know what? I'll start that again. Today's situation is like water flowing between the walls of a deep ravine. It is talking about a real life situations that you are now familiar with. Something about it is dangerous to your best interests, but the way is clear. This is no time to be reckless or dishonest. No matter what you face, simply do your best at work and remain true to your own self and your own sense of personal integrity. You may have something important to teach, so be constant and consistent. That's quite cool. Alrighty, so... Right, let's have a look. People messaging me, that's all I'd like to see. But I was kind of slightly disappointed there. Only 4 people actually put that question to me. Expecting a lot more than that. A lot more, but okay. Because I didn't tell anybody I was putting it up. Right, let's go back to what we're doing here. Right, gotta go now. Run out of washing up liquid and need to eat. Jen, that doesn't sound right. That sounds like you're going to eat washing up liquid. Don't be eating washing up liquid, Jen. I know I told you to wash your mouth out, but that's taking it too far. Come on, focus. Right, let's go back to what we're doing tonight. Here's a good point of view to follow what I was just talking about. This is a really good point of view. Keep this in mind.
You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like that. Thank you.
What a wonderful message there for Stella. That's Alex's future mother-in-law. Don't stop till you get enough, girl. Keep it going. And a big, big, wonderful happy birthday. Keep rocking, girl. His little birdies. At least you breed birds. You need to talk to Johanna.
To the beat with a passion,
say girl.
Mr. Lover Party's happy.
You know that thing.
Doing anything to women, I say girl. I'll take you with us all night.
This is Shaggy talking here, Alex.
Mr. Lover Party's happy.
You know that thing. Doing anything you women, I say.
Well, before Alex disappears and go off making that lasagna. Actually, I made spaghetti meatballs tonight. I thought I'd play this one for her especially. Well, just while we were doing all this, I was talking to her ladyship here, and she was telling me that I need patience. Would you agree with that? Would you agree that I need patience? I don't think I do. I've never had any patience, so why would I need them? Use your mic. She's pushed the mic away.
I'll push my mic away because I've been doing a read for his lordship here. his last card was patience because he doesn't have any.
No, I don't.
At all.
None. My mum used to say to me I was born without a patient bone.
I put my coat on and he says to me, "You're back yet?"
No, when you're about to leave, I say, "You're back yet?"
He says, "We need milk. You're back yet?"
What does Johan say? Yes, Paul? What for? Is that for me asking, do I need patience? What I need is a holiday.
Yeah, I need a holiday, definitely. And I've been saying that for what? How many weeks?
Day and night.
Day morning, and night.
Noon, night, even in her sleep. Oh my God, you've never seen anything like it.
We both need holiday.
No, I'm just going to go and become a monk.
I just want to tell you all the things you are and all the things you mean to me.
Ooh, Alex, my hunky self. I like that.
Hunky.
And stunning hunky. Johanna. Or it could be honking Johanna and stunning myself. Alex, thank you for everything you've done. Thanks for your support, darling.
Thanks, Alex.
Yes on the Cadbury's buttons, no on the Milky Coffee. But yes on the Cadbury's buttons. Love Cadbury's buttons.
You're the answer to my prayer, and you're with me everywhere. You're my angel, miracle. You're all I need tonight. Give me shelter from the rain. You breathe life. Tonight.
Well, I just clicked in me. I am a bit dumb at times, but Lisa, you were the boss of the Boscow, and I met you in the show up there in St. Denis, didn't I? Or St. Denis. Am I right? I was driving past the Boscow, and when was it? The day before yesterday, wasn't it? Or was it yesterday? And I said to Johanna, that was my first ever gig, ever there, right there. I can't believe it. Oh, my God. Yes, I do look after you, Lisa. You're right. It's your turn to look after me now. My little bouncerette. I thought I might just do something off the cuff. This is from one of my first albums, Diversity of Love. Yes, my aunt was a boss. Yes, I knew I met Lisa. This one, click, light on. Got it. There you go. This is one from my first album. This is called Diversity. Oh, sorry, the album is called Diversity of Love. This song is called In the Beginning. Yes, Lisa, I remember that. I do. Not yet, Philippa. So that was this track called the In the Beginning, which is the extended mix, which is the elongated 12-inch version of Days Gone By, which is available on the album Diversity of Love. Don't buy them off iTunes just yet, okay? Brand new shop being released very, very soon. You need to talk to Johanna about that, and they will be available on that, as well as coming up very soon, the new EP, five-single EP called Rain, which we're doing especially for children with cancer and children's hospice. That's coming up in the next month or so. We're working on that literally as we speak. And tomorrow I'll be slaving away here in the studios working on that one as well. And that's coming up very soon. I can't believe how quickly we've gone through tonight, babe. It's only 10 minutes left. I do hope you guys have enjoyed it. Well, the good news is it's only 48 hours till we're back. We'll be back Friday night with the All Request Friday. You guys really make the show. Please, 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 please send this show out to all of your friends and family. Get them to come along, especially Philippa. Come on, let's get a big following out there in New Zealand, and that will make it all the easier for us to come over and do a tour. So I promise you with all my heart, I am absolutely, totally up for coming over to do a tour in New Zealand. You can be sure of that.
You're listening to my dad on Spirit Quest Radio. Spirit Quest Radio.
You are listening to The Paul Francis Show, brought to you by Elm Tree Productions.
For more details, contact www.paulfrancis.net. Why not text your request on 07837-627-942? That's 07837-627-942. Send your requests in right now.
You are listening to The Paul Francis Show, brought to you by Elm Tree Productions.
Available to you on Spreaker.com, www.spreaker.com/ The Paul Francis Show. Visit our site on www.paulfrancis.net. That's www.paulfrancis.net.
You are listening to The Paul Francis Show, brought to you by Elm Tree Productions.
Yes, you are listening to The Paul Francis Show, brought to you specifically by Spirit Quest Radio, part of the Quest Corporation Limited. Worldwide. Big thank you to everybody from one end of the world to the other, to all of our lovely friends and fans over there in the United States, to all of our friends and family and fans here in the UK and Ireland, and of course all of our friends, family and fans over there in New Zealand, Australia. Thank you so, so much for all of your support. We have reached the end of the show, but as I say, it's not too far away. We're going to be around here on Friday. So make sure you're part of the show. Make sure you get yourself together and be a big part of our show this coming Friday night, all right? It's important that you're here.
Furball.
So I do hope you guys have enjoyed the show tonight and enjoyed. I loved that experiment. That experiment was amazing. It was really, really quite cool. Thank you, Susan. You're a superstar. So we're going to say a really warm-hearted, loving good night to you. Tomorrow I'm going to be in the studio all day. Working, and then by the time I finish, I'll be working a bit more. And she drives me like she's a slave driver. But between the two of us, we wish you a wonderful, wonderful, warm good night. And we will see you Friday night. Until then, be safe, look after yourselves, and remember, communicate, appreciate, and validate everybody in your life so a medium never has to do it for you. Good night.
Here. Angels are always with you. We are always with you. Around you, we love you. Ask us, and we'll be always with you. with you. We love to play. We love laughing. We protect you. We love you. Call on us. We are always here. Angels, we are always here.